Howdy to everybody in Dodge City, Kansas listening. A big howdy to you, a big cowboy howdy. And also howdy's in appropriate here for Tucson with the rodeo just in town last weekend. But we are dealing with a different rodeo, the rodeo of God in Christ, the Holy Spirit, trying to ride bulls, trying to ride animals, so that you can stay on the back and be, you know, well, the goal in Acts is that the Spirit of God would ride the apostles, ride on the apostles, and go and move through the apostles, like Jesus coming in on Palm Sunday on that colt. In the same way, Jesus comes in through the Word of God as we preach it and proclaim it, and as the disciples did. Chapter 4, verse 12, I want to just reread that from yesterday. Salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name given under heaven by which we must be saved. This is going to be a lot of contention over this verse in the church, and also just among individual believers and non-believers in the next decades. This idea is repulsive to the modern mind that there's only one way to salvation. And Oprah Winfrey once said that it's impossible that there's only one way to salvation. Well, that's not true. It's possible. It can be. It may not be. But it's not impossible. We say there's only one way to heaven. It's through Jesus Christ. It's not through becoming a part of the church. It is through Jesus Christ. There is salvation found in nobody else. It doesn't say in no other religion. It says in nobody else. And so when we talk about salvation being exclusively in Christ, we are saying that it's not a church matter per se. It is about knowing Jesus Christ. The Christian religion is no better than any other religion as far as you being involved with it in order to get you somewhere. Because religion doesn't get you to God. Jesus Christ gets you to God. And religion, properly understood, will help protect you from straying or erring from what is true. When they saw the courage of Peter and John and realized that they were unschooled, ordinary men, isn't that cool? Unschooled, ordinary? Kind of makes you think that you might be worthy to be able to serve God. Not worthy necessarily. We're not worthy, but we're called and we're empowered by God. Ordinary men, ordinary people God uses. They were astonished and they took note that these men had been with Jesus. But since they could see the man who was being healed, who had been healed, the paralytic, standing there with them, there was nothing they could say. So they ordered them to withdraw from the Sanhedrin and then to confer together. What are we going to do with these men, they asked. Everyone living in Jerusalem knows they have performed a notable sign, and we cannot deny it. But to stop this thing from spreading any further among the people, we must warn them to speak no longer to anyone in this name. Then they called them in again and commanded them not to teach or speak at all in the name of Jesus. But Peter and John replied, "What is right in God's eyes? To listen to you or to him? You be the judges. As for us, we cannot help speaking about what we've seen and heard." After further threats, they let them go. They could not decide how to punish them because all the people were praising God for what happened. For the man who was miraculously healed was over 40 years old. God moving miraculously and supernaturally in the world is important. It's important for us to note that, to speak that, to share that. Because as you are finding out after the healing of the paralytic, many people seriously considered Jesus who hadn't considered him before, the name of Jesus, this one that they thought was dead. And so miracles and healings and God moving today helps encourage faith. In third world countries right now, in Africa, parts of South America, even in China, many people are coming to faith because, well, many are seeing dreams and visions, which is supernatural encounter, but many are seeing it being done in the Christian community, healings and miracles. And then just like here, they're paralyzed. The leaders didn't know what to do. How can they do anything? Because something happened to this man that was miraculous. It kind of hinted that these men were onto something true. On their release, Peter and John went back to their own people and reported all the chief priests and elders had said to them. When they heard this, they raised their voices together in prayer to God. Sovereign Lord, you made heaven and earth and sea and everything in them. You spoke by the Holy Spirit through the mouth of your servant David. Then down to verse 27. Indeed, Herod and Pontius Pilate met together with the Gentiles and the people of Israel in this city to conspire against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed. So now they're praying. The Christians are praying. And this is what they prayed. Now, Lord, consider their threats and enable your servants to speak your word with great boldness. Stretch out your hand to heal and perform signs and wonders through the name of your holy servant Jesus. And then they prayed, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and they spoke the word of God boldly, and the meeting place was shaken. They saw a miraculous movement of God through the shaking of the house after their prayer. You know, much of Christianity is shut off in the West to the miraculous. But the miraculous is one of the greatest, weightiest evidence for the reality of Jesus Christ that there is. Here, the healing of the lame man wasn't just for the lame man's benefit. It was that all who saw and beheld would be driven to the possibility of accepting Jesus Christ and repenting. That's why we have a book we're reading now through Lent. Our Lenten challenge is to read about Milbank, South Dakota, one church. And it's not a huge church, one church, and there are 40 God stories. We're doing that so that we can begin to believe more when we pray, trusting that God can do anything. He chooses not to do everything, but he can do anything. He can do anything. And we got to start acting like that. We act as if God isn't there, or God isn't strong, or that God isn't loving. We act like that. Well, let's really believe it. Heavenly Father, thank you that you're real. Thank you for all your activity in our lives through the course of our lives. We pray like these followers of Jesus did 2,000 years ago. We pray, God, that you would heal and stretch out your hand to heal and perform signs and wonders through your holy name, the holy name of Jesus, your servant. Look for God. Watch for God. Pray to God as if he can do anything. Let's glorify Jesus today. Ciao.